What's up? Seat Story Cup 3 is back. We're getting towards the end of the day.
Yep.
Some exciting things still to come. It's late, so maybe we'll have some more missed lethals. What do you think, Gara?
Yeah.
Let's hope so. But this match is going to be Johnny Druid going up against the Ude.
Toide? Gara?
The Ude Sandstorm.
Toide.
Yeah, it's Toide.
It's like very German. Maybe that's why you
tried.
Toide. Yeah.
Yeah, see?
Not bad.
But before we start that, let's go ahead and jump over to my screen. I want to show you guys a little thing that you need to go do right now.
What do I have to do?
Well, you need to go to facebook.com/TakeTV. Look, I know that you love it when, you know, your mom is posting something that she found in her email on Facebook and stuff. But even better than that would be following TakeTV on Facebook, because
that doesn't sound very good.
Well, that's what people use Facebook for, right? That and also like stalking photos of girls that they used to like and stuff like that. It's, okay. I mean, there's a lot of different ways to use Facebook, but this is one way.
All right.
And look right here. Seat Story Cup 3 raffle. What are we in right now? Is this Seat Story Cup 3?
Do you want to maybe go around a few more times?
Here, I'll exit. I'll make a figure eight.
Did you even like sign Artosis like through that?
Okay. Wait.
That was pretty good.
Wait, I'm not done.
Oh.
Beautiful.
And then I cross the T and a dot the I.
Wow.
Bam, Artosis and a little lightning bolt underneath it.
Not bad.
You click on this. Seat Story Cup 3 raffle. Mm-hmm. Fans only. All right.
So you got to be a fan first.
Yeah, if you don't like this and you're just here trying to steal a seat, get out.
Wow.
So go ahead, follow Take TV on Facebook, and you can win some awesome stuff. You can win some seats.
Oh, a few more.
I was actually informed that they were watching when I was like, oh, wow, I wish I had one of those seats.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy called up Take TV and said, we will give him a seat.
Wow.
How sick is that?
Well,
I don't need to enter anything anymore, but you guys do. And so go down here. You can win a seat. You can win 20 Hearthstone packs or 100 euros on Kingwin. You can win Heroes of the Storm beta keys. That's a really fun game. You can win these cool hoodies and shirts and sweatpants and whatnot.
We're getting some of those anyway, right? We basically get everything they get.
We're not getting any of this, basically. Oh. But like,
yeah, I guess.
Yeah, we already have beta keys. Whatever. Anyways, go down here and register, guys, because this is some high-quality products, and they are supporting this awesome tournament, which is indeed awesome because you're watching it and you know that already. So definitely check that out.
All right. Well, let's check out what we're heading into here.
Well,
I don't think we're actually spectating RDU. I think we're going to see Toide.
No. It's Toide against Johnny. So it's going to be Johnny, and I believe he is
on RDU number one legend.
I played him to rank one legend. That was very funny.
Okay.
Together. Not account sharing.
It was two versus
one. Wait, how do you play together without account sharing?
I told him basically what to mulligan and what to play every
turn. He did it like this, right? Like, they were on an iPad, right?
Yeah.
So basically, RDU's holding the iPad, and Gara takes RDU's hand like this, and he's like,
No.
And he's dragging the cards up for
okay.
him.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's like,
is that how you do it?
I touch the crip. Yeah, that's how I do it.
Okay.
I do it very stylistically.
And now the real story?
Yeah.
he said, like,
Gara, that was the real story.
Gara, teach me Shaman, because he's not that good with Shaman. He's good with other decks. And I basically just, explained him, like coached him, and then we just played to rank one legend.
He's rank one legend with Shaman.
Yeah.
The deck that
face,
other players
face
are
Shaman,
fun
like
of.
Mech Shaman.
Yeah.
With
whose deck was it?
It's still a bad deck. In
that
my
must
opinion.
Be really OP. You
yeah.
probably don't even need to calculate lethal with that deck, right?
No. You always. I mean, you have lethal in your starting hand.
Uh-huh.
Most of the time. So.
Oh, man.
All right.
That's awesome.
That's good stuff.
Okay.
Okay,
I
Vortex
think
is the one you want to follow.
You're getting
he's on Vortex accounts.
Let's see who did. Yeah, okay.
All right, excellent. So we have this game starting up, guys. And let's take a look at what classes. It's going to be from Johnny. He's going to be starting with that Warrior deck.
Toyota's playing the Tempo Mage. Tempo Mage can like really tempo a Warrior out.
It certainly can. And let's see what the bans are. We had a ban on Shaman.
Yeah, that deck seemed ridiculous.
That's cool.
Shaman cards and Neptulon.
Yeah, that was sick.
Kind of
won him the game.
Hmm? Yeah.
Neptulon won him the game.
Neptulon's a good card.
Yeah.
Paladin
I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course Neptulon is a good card. I mean, it isn't any Dr. Boom, but yeah.
You play both.
Yeah, yeah, you should.
That's
BGH
the trick.
Can't do both.
That's the trick.
You know what you gotta do? You gotta put a panda in your BGH deck.
I have a BGH deck?
Yeah, man. Your deck with BGH in it. It's a BGH deck.
I actually had BGH decks where, like, it was like the old Paladin decks that, like, every creature had Battlecry, so you put pandas in there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, well, if I have pandas, yeah, yeah. I want to put BGH. If I have BGH, I want to put in Dark Iron, so I could Dark Iron BGH the panda, the BGH to BGH something else.
Yeah, that was sweet.
But the problem with that is you generally just lose when you're trying to dunk pandas on the board.
I actually wanted to do something. Like, I wanted to play one Brewmaster in the Priest deck, so you can Shadow Madness,
yeah.
Brewmaster, Recombulator, all that fancy stuff.
The Recombulator is so much stronger than yeah. Brewmaster for that, because
yeah.
you like with the Recombulator, you generally gain tempo.
Yeah.
Sometimes not,
yeah.
but usually it works.
Indeed. So, here we are, guys.
So he doesn't have the Win X. That's already a bad start. It decreased his chance to win the game drastically.
Yeah.
The what?
The Win X.
Win eggs?
Yeah, the Win X. You don't know the Win X?
Fiery Win X.
That's how everyone calls it.
Oh, Fiery Win Axe.
Yeah. yeah.
I thought you said Win Eggs. I'm like, Nerubian no. eggs are not that good, Gaara.
They're not good, out yet. Yeah. Dragon Egg will be a sick card.
Now, the issue here is you have some pretty good tempo plays, just not against the Warrior going second with coin in hand.
Oh, that's actually a cool deck from Toyota when you look at the next play.
Yeah, the next play
is really
good. It's
not a standard deck.
Well, it's a tempo
yeah.
mage.
That's cool. I'm bored by mech mages.
I think you actually Kirin Tor without Counterspell. Oh, never mind. You portal.
Because he has the coin?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's but when you think about it, it's such a sick tempo play.
Yeah. Well, burning the coin is pretty neat, but...
Coin into Steel Acolyte. Secrets. I mean, he like when you really think of... So he actually did it.
Wow, he skipped Counterspell.
Good.
Yeah.
I think that's how...
He was listening to Crib.
Well, I thought the portal's probably better outcome.
Yeah. It's very difficult. Like, I talked about it with many people. Like, when is the perfect turn to play Unstable Portal? It really depends. Also, when you... Like, it's interesting when you have, like, Mad Scientist, when you have alternative plays, if it's better to play the Unstable Portal because you never know what you get. It's, like, very...
It's like a box of chocolates, guys.
Yeah.
You just never know what you're going to get.
Wow.
Mogre the Ogre, dude. He just wanted
no,
to run.
No, Mogre, you know what you're going to get. Misery.
Misery. You don't know in what form, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Imagine this. Hold on. If Mogre the Ogre was in that game that RDU just played, would he have hit lethal?
Oh.
50%?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that was so mean. I feel so bad right now.
That's a gruel.
That's a nice turn 5 play.
Wow.
It doesn't have the BGH. I mean, you go for it, right?
Yeah.
If he doesn't have BGH, he wins the game.
That's pretty sick.
The Shredder, you can't actually attack the Snowchugger.
Yeah, that's bad.
You have to kill the Kirin Tor.
Wow.
Because you can't.
You know what you could do? You could attack the Snowchugger and then pop him with Cruel Taskmaster to get to get your Milhouse Mana Storm out of that shell.
That was not. No.
The best.
You don't think so?
No.
Not that good. Okay.
The sickest part is even if he has the BGH for Gruul, that Dr. GG will just
that's
seal the game.
Sick, yeah.
Dr. GG?
Yeah, that's how we call it.
Okay. Yeah, he spent so much time building the board, and then Dr. Boom just does it by himself.
Yeah. Dr. GG, it's like...
Full board.
Yeah. It's like, okay, you kept the Doctor, you put GG because he ends the game, but we could be more clever, I think. Like, what about Dr.
Juggler's great.
Dr. Broom, because he cleans it up.
That's actually really good.
What, the Juggler? Yeah.
Okay, I totally would have acolyted there, not armor passed.
Well, why would you armor? It doesn't really do much. He needs, I don't know.
Gruul boys.
I can't wait. Why is he... What?
What?
Is that an Azure Drake on his mouse click? That
yeah.
has to be a spectate bug. Can we restart?
Which one? Both?
Oh, come on.
Crip,
got
you. I played with it. No, I played with it.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's what happened.
Yeah, totally.
Duh.
Oh, there's that fiery. Oh, no. No.
It's not a Winax anymore.
He didn't man up and play the Gruul.
Pain, speak to me.
Sometimes you're going to man up.
Another Acolyte. Well, that's not.
That's actually very greedy that he saved the Acolyte for the Taskmaster Acolyte.
Yeah. Like, what was Toyota going to do? Attack the last Snow Chugga into the Acolyte and then ping it?
Yeah, never.
No chance.
No way. Yeah. No way, like, literally.
Yeah.
But that's, like, an awkward spot. Like, if you play Gruul now, why wouldn't you have played it last turn? It just increases your chances that he will have the BGH now because he drew cards with the Acolyte.
I think because like his hand was maybe a bit shoddy, he was thinking of dropping the counterspell before a big creature.
Yeah, I mean, he could play both his secrets this turn. It's doable.
Okay.
You really have to freeze face because of the Azure Drake, though. Like, you can't trade with the Taskmaster. It's like he didn't need the draw from the Azure Drake, right? You usually play it if you need the draw or you have more options, but he had like this very expensive hand. So it's kind of weird to play the Azure Drake before the 8-8.
I do have to mention, I don't think I've ever seen a foil Gruul played in my entire life in Hearthstone.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
His eye like pops out and stuff. That's pretty neat.
I've never seen a normal Gruul being played.
I have.
I've played many games.
I've played Arena. In Arena, he's okay.
Oh, he only has one eye? He's a Cyclops?
Maybe you should just like not talk about lore of cards.
He is a Cyclops, though, right?
What a role player.
Yeah.
Hold on, let me show the stream on this one.
He doesn't care about the game anymore. He's like, what? Yeah. He has only one eye?
Because it looks there like he has two, and then it glows, and I'm like, oh, does he have one?
Yeah, in the Burning Crusade expansion, World of Warcraft, there was actually, like, I don't know, like at least 24 of these guys, they all look the same and very obviously had one eye.
Okay.
But that's all right.
What, did you read all the books?
No, you just see them walking around.
Yeah, you just play the game.
Oh, okay.
But that's actually very unfortunate that he doesn't have an answer to kill it. He has, like, a full hand and cards.
Mm. Well, you might get one. Let's see.
Oh, Gruul task. Holy cow.
That's a big Acolyte.
Well, he can kill it at least. That shield slam. Plus both these minions.
Oh my god.
He's pretty sick.
Easiest removal of his life.
That's painful. That Gruul.
Value.
Yeah.
That's a good value.
That's a good unstable portal, I have to say.
All right. He had, I mean, that's like the safest Dr. GG ever after seeing that play. Like, he just invested like 50 cards to kill the Gruul. What to do? He totally has the BGH.
Here's the thing. Like, let's say you're Toyota, right? And you play, you think what Gara just said. You're like, all right. And you play the Dr. Boom. And then like, the first card of his hand is a BGH that comes out and kills him. You're like, wait, what?
Then I would be like, you got me. You got me.
You're like, that's slow play. Okay.
The good part about Dr. GG is even if he has the BGH, the bombs still kill two minions at least.
Yeah. Or do 8 to face.
They can kill 3 minions.
They can kill 4.
They can kill 4.
They can kill 4 minions, that's true.
No, actually, they can kill more than that.
You know what? If they hit an explosive sheep.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Exactly. Man.
Or what about an abomination? Imagine they hit that. They could kill, like, 14 minions.
No, actually, they couldn't.
They could. If there's a Valen out and abomination.
Yeah.
And your little get over here, everyone get in here guy, Grim Patron. Yeah. All
right. Are we playing Mortal Kombat right now?
Why is that? Are you playing Mortal Kombat? What?
What I like the most on Ladder is when they casually trade the Boombots into a giant and kill the giant with it. It's like, might as well try. And it works.
This will probably work.
Time.
Yeah.
No problem.
All right. So
I trust.
Easiest rag of his life.
Yeah. Do you YOLO the rag or do you use a bomb to kill her?
Yeah, you can trade one bomb to kill the shield maiden. That's a good
so
trade.
Funny.
I think you do. I think you just throw some boombots in there.
One is enough usually.
Like, no, you guys don't even understand. Like, Don't you have lethal here?
Six.
That's eight.
Oh, yeah, true.
Yeah, you do.
Plus eight, yeah.
Ragnaros and Boombot's face.
I started always
That's
to count.
Lethal.
Yeah, I always I started to count Boombot's always as eight damage. Now you play them, it's eight damage.
I don't know.
I think no, I actually think you attack into the shield main to see if you can lethal the warrior. Like, think of all the headaches that you save.
I mean, he has so much problems, like, to remove the Dr. Boom and the... Guys, why don't you just play the Ragnaros? What can you do?
I have a serious question right now. Guys, why doesn't Freeze Mage play Dr. Boom?
Like, Sixto actually Seven said that. Like, Shredder, the same with Shredders, because Shredders are also, like, pretty balanced. He just plays Shredders and Dr. Boom.
No,
Shredders,
Shredders, I think, actually pretty weak if you're behind.
Yeah.
Yeah. You need, like, something before the Shredder. It doesn't matter what it is. Just some annoying something to deal with the other annoying something so your Shredder can trade up.
And most
and then again,
it's
trade up.
Yeah, but what about
Mil-house.
Dr. Boom? Like, Dr. Boom would fit in Freeze Mage, right?
He would fit in every deck.
Yeah. I think so. It's kind of close. Usually around that time, you're just dying every turn.
Yeah, but, like, worst case scenario, you hit them for 8 in the face, right?
Yeah.
No, it's actually 15.
The
worst case is the Boombots hit 4 apiece and then Dr. Boom just lands that 7.
It's so sick.
It happens every time. It's like such a frustrating position when you have like weapons and you can't use them for the entire game. The Snowchugger is still alive.
The Chugga keeps on chugging. That not only is the Chugga still on the board, that Chugga I think is at 12 damage.
This is like a cool new thing that we're doing, trying to keep track of damage from 2 attack minions throughout the game.
But what does the warrior do? He has a counter spell, he has a mirror entity, he's frozen. And a full board.
He armors up and passes. That's what else do you want him to
do? You play the Acolyte for one year, that's what you're going to do. You need the card roll.
May as well play that shield slam to take out the counter spell.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, next turn Alexstrasza. That was actually not stupid.
Yeah.
Why would you not shield slam? I mean, you know it's counterspell, right? Probably, right?
What like, to
yeah.
do?
What else can it be?
It's yeah, no, that's it.
Here's lethal. Boom, bye.
Yeah, hit him face for. I mean,
oh,
on.
It's certain.
And? Second best outcome.
Rip.
Second best outcome.
I'm sorry, guys.
Second best outcome. Cheers. All right. Next shot. You don't need the rag, man. You have a frostball, that's enough. All right, he's going for the BM.
Frostball was enough.
I know. It's like, yeah. Might as well.
Oh, that was brutal. He was actually frozen the entire game. He's sitting there with weapons in his hand. He's
there's
just like,
three
oh.
Three weapons in his hand.
There's
at the
a counterspell out. It's yeah. just a mirror entity. It's like there's literally nothing he can do. Like, oh, my God.
Yeah, well, that was quite a game.
It certainly was.
Did we get to quick check on the Dex band?
Yeah, it's a Shaman band for Tude.
Yeah.
And then Paladin band for
Paladin.
Johnny.
Okay.
Tweede.
So he still has the Hunter. Hunter from Tweede.
Yeah.
Now his other three decks that we haven't seen the Hunter.
Yeah, I believe that was
banned. But the three decks in the match just before this one, they were all fairly unique. So
yeah, this
I'm
could
wondering,
be like a mid-range or something.
I'm wondering if that that is consistent throughout actually all the decks, or if we're
could
seeing
a
straight-up face Hunter again.
I bet you that this is going to be like a mid-range Hunter. He's like really doing his own thing.
Confirm. Damn, it's not working.
Wouldn't that be funny if you could do that? Busy night, but there's
always room right. for another.
Oh, it could be a mid-range. You don't play a web spinner in complete face Hunter anymore, so definitely could be.
It is because you, as you said, you don't play it in face Hunter.
What if it's a Feigned Death Hunter?
That would be so cool.
I mean, it could be, yeah.
But Brainhead did play it first.
What, Feigned Death?
Didn't he?
I played it. Usually, like, I...
Did
I,
you?
Yeah. It didn't... like the coolest play was coin Nerubian Egg into Nerubian Egg into Feign Death into Feign Death. That was like the best tempo I ever had. It was like pretty cool.
Yeah, but then you don't really do anything for like the first part of the game.
I mean, you win. You have four Nerubs and two eggs.
You're actually observing the wrong guy here.
I am. Okay.
Yeah, you gotta exit that.
All right. Well, Armorsmith is pretty nice. Cruel Task is pretty nice.
Which one do I?
You should be on.
I'm liking what I'm seeing here.
Yep, there he is.
All right. Sorry.
I think you actually kill the mad scientist because if he's playing web spinner, he's probably not playing explosive.
Oh, baby.
Feign
Death. You called it. You saw the web spinner. Wow. Crip saw the web spinner. It's like, hey, that's a Feign
Death. Yeah. That has to be a Feign Death deck.
Has to be.
It has to be.
And I tell you what, if he plays that Feign Death with those two out, oh my God. King Crush, you know, crazy stuff going on. Oh my God!
Hey, that's what I call these.
Oh
RNG.
My God!
Oh my God!
What are we even looking at?
This is getting out of control.
This is so funny to me. Okay, look, can we talk about this? First off, it's a Feign Death deck, he got a beast that has a death rattle, but not just that. He's playing against Warrior, and that will be his third Savannah High main.
Yeah,
that is automatically like, I am probably going to win this game.
It's not just that. Like, if the first High Main lives, and it probably will, because it's against the Warrior, as we just mentioned.
Yeah.
The Baron Feign Death play will actually just be a 2-mana 4/2/2 Hyenas play. At the least.
I've also never seen the Mad Scientist into Baron.
He better have a brawl, man. I just can't even believe this. This is awesome. I'm glad that Toyd is in this tournament bringing decks like this.
Like, he was talking to me, Gar, I'm so happy you manned up to bring new decks. Like, I'm totally on your side.
Oh, explosive. That was a bad trap, actually.
Oh, yeah. Should have went for the Feign Death, man.
Yeah.
To increase the odds. Oh, that's not a bad draw. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Well?
Maybe he wants it to die to a shield slam, like him to waste a shield slam or something on that.
Yeah, he can definitely kill it, right?
He can kill it with attack in, armor up, and shield slam.
Yeah. But do you do it? You just play the Acolyte or not? I mean, it's a 1/7, not beast. Like, what? It's not a big threat. It's not a big threat.
No, you have to use
shield slam. Soon as you see him, you got to get rid of him, okay? He is one of the four horsemen.
Yeah.
Okay?
No, you're probably, like, joking and stuff, but that's actually true. Like, if you leave Baron out,
Yeah.
Like, you see Baron, you're like, okay, that's what I'm playing against.
The four horsemen.
Which means
a joke,
that card is in that deck for a very good reason.
Yeah, this is... Toyota wants to win money. He got top four at the last seat story, okay? He is not pulling your leg with this deck.
Yeah.
You have to kill that.
But no, how can you get punished by leaving it alive? Like, you're not going to play...
Oh, you want to see? Are you ready?
You're not going to play a Death Rattle Minion plus Feign Death in for 5 mana.
Yeah, but it's going to be a Sludge Belcher. Oh, God, Dr. Boom. Those Boom Bots are going to do, like, 16 damage.
Yeah.
16 damage.
No. It's Dr. Boom, and then you Feign Death, then kill the Boom Bots.
I actually did that. That's, like, 16 damage. Yeah.
That's crazy. No, it's actually 60.
That's OTK.
Yeah.
I mean, just Dr.
That's
Boom
a new combo deck right
just
there.
Just Dr. Boom with one Feign Death is, like, 8 damage to the face.
Yeah.
And then another 8 damage next turn. That's already a winning combo. It's like Force of Nature, Savage Roar.
That's awesome.
All right. Well, what do we have here? Suddenly, that Baron's looking like a little problematic.
Scary.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should have taken it out.
He doesn't have a chance to now. No,
there's nothing to be done.
I think the best play is to Cruel Task the Armorsmith, then Armor Up, then Shield Slam the Belcher, kill the remainder with the
I think that's too tryhard.
That's too tryhard?
Just Taskmaster the Acolyte. Find, like, execute and stuff. You have a board. Let him trade.
What happens if you brawl with a bunch of Death Rattle Minions out like this?
It just looks like you did nothing.
I think
five
that's
mana
true,
wipe
right?
your board. Well, that card doesn't have a death rattle. What is that?
That's like a very quick shot.
Maybe he didn't have two Feign Deaths and he needed to use another card.
Yeah.
I mean, you just slam the Mufasa.
Yeah.
And win.
But he could get two slimes right now with Feign Death.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that's like that's almost crazy. A good play.
It's better than Echoing Ooze with nothing.
It is better than Echoing Ooze.
Yeah.
It's a better,
strictly better.
Yeah. Because you do have taunt.
But when you really think about it, if he could have like removed the Baron Geddon last turn, he would have done it, right? Or the Sludge Belcher.
It's not actually a Baron Geddon.
Yeah, no, it's actually
it's a Baron just without the Geddon.
Yeah. I'm actually like, wait a second, I haven't seen this card. Okay, Rivendare. Baron Rivendare. Is he like related to Baron Geddon in some way, Krip?
No, they're just Barons, you know.
Oh yeah,
there's
Baron
that
like
brawl
a,
actually.
Oh, that's just, well. I what again? What does that do?
Oh,
well,
it gives
what
him
it
a lot
does
of
is it makes it so the Baron Geddon wins the brawl, and then spawns two slimes and four hyenas beside it.
It makes the game a lot of fun. You're totally brawling.
That's like lethal. That brawl is lethal.
Like if anything survives from Toyota, that's terrible. It's like 50% chance to absolutely lose the game.
I don't even. This is getting really confusing for me, like looking at these interactions right now. Like, should he try to? Because he has some death
he
rattles.
Can't
could
some
he
diamond.
Steal?
That would
could
be terrible.
Somehow steal this Baron Rivendare?
Yeah. YOLO Sylvanas.
I think he's going to attack there and then brawl.
All right, that's not too bad.
No.
Would you kill a slime? I mean.
Not if you were going to do that.
If Rivendell survives, that's not cool. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that makes more
sense. Yeah, that makes the brawl really good next turn. He has a lot of armor.
Not exactly, actually.
Well, we could see the Feign Death coming up and just have like a board full of hyenas.
You just play the Dr. GG and win. That's how it usually goes.
Oh my
goes.
God,
like, I don't
you're
know.
Right.
That's
yeah.
like.
I wish he had a prep in his hand.
The best
imagine
part
if
is,
he had a prep.
The best part is he's going to play Dr. Boom. It's going to get brawled. Sylvanas is going to take like a crap hyena that's going to instantly die to the bomb.
Yeah, that's actually what's going to happen. Because the bomb definitely is the last one.
Yeah.
I mean, when you look... Man, that hand is so juicy. How can you lose? I hope he brawls and Rivendell survives. Like, then it's going to get very confusing.
Oh my god.
Because I don't actually know what's going to happen.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Like,
if Geddon survives... sorry.
Well, it triggers all of these death rattles, then Sylvanas tries to steal something.
Yes, exactly.
And it would probably be like...
It would be like a hyena.
It would be a hyena.
That would instantly die to one of the four bomb hits.
But will you get four bombs?
Yes.
Yeah, of
still.
Course. Mm. What if the Rivendare...
If Rivendare survives.
Oh, if Rivendare survives. But it will get... Stolen? What if it gets stolen by someone?
I think Toyota doesn't know, but he's going to play this anyways for fun.
Yeah, that's how you play Hearthstone. Like, you can play Dr. Boom, you do it, and you win the game, like 90%, 95% of the game.
Yeah, and that
was
a turn 7.
Oh, it's like, oh, my opponent has 6 creatures. Let's just brawl.
Good one.
Oh, man.
That brawl is going to be so fun. I hope he does it.
I think he has to.
Because he has also death rattle minions, it's very gonna be very interesting. Like, what if you steal the Rivendare and you Shredder dies? Do you get 2 minions then from the Shredder? I want to see that.
Yeah, you do. If you steal the that.
When was the Shredder played?
It was played after.
Well, the death rattle. Yeah, the death rattle of Sylvanas will trigger second. So no, that would not work. It would not work.
That would be so awesome.
If the order was changed on the play order, then it would. But then you'd get a Doomsayer.
Oh my god.
That's just the way this game works.
It's getting better and better. Do it, sir. No. You would not kill the slime, though, if you plan to brawl.
Yeah, I think he's thinking of hitting that, because it overfills the board with hyenas.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, the value.
What's he get?
The value. One less hyena. That's, I mean, that's like... That's 8 damage to a...
Yeah.
Wait, would you really... Trade first before you brawl? Is that good?
I don't think so.
Yeah, because Sylvanas will steal whatever.
Yeah, there's going to be probably something left on his opponent's side. Did he not get to armor up?
Wow.
Wow, that's easy.
Wow.
Easy, easy.
That RNG.
Calculated.
I guess so.
Calculated. that was fucking amazing. How did that happen? Now he's gonna be... Oh, yeah, you just...
Oh, God.
I mean, that's not big enough to steal.
Do you really want to waste your feigned death?
No, not yet,
shredder?
Not yet.
Not yet?
It's juicy, though. What can the warrior do?
Yeah, Savannah Highman.
Yeah, why not, right? Another Savannah Highman.
Yeah.
We have a couple more of those.
Seems
in
good.
Deck.
And then Sylvanas and feigned death. Oh, my God.
Yeah, one...
This is getting so dirty, this game.
No, it's going to be a Dr. Boom from the warrior. Sylvanas' play is going to suck.
Yeah, Dr. GG. Oh, okay. He has his own one. The tides have turned.
No, he's... Oh, my God.
Oh, come... Yes,
he wants to shield slam it.
Yeah. And then what?
He has like 1 in 7 chance to pick the right card.
1 in 7? Here's the thing, though. I don't think that Big Game Hunter's on the table right now. And I don't think Harrison is either. So I would say that's 1 in 5.
That's okay-ish.
Yeah.
No, you don't get the Doomsayer. That's... I mean, he can't technically kill it from what he sees, right? He doesn't know he has the juicy bow.
What about just Eaglehorn?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Eaglehorn, maybe kill command that 5/5.
Yeah, you definitely kill command. You don't want to freeze trap
Yeah.
Like this guy.
Really? Yeah. Do you care?
Yeah, you kind of do, because you kind of wasted all your big friends.
Okay.
you play 2 high mains and Dr. Boom. There's not much left.
Well, he still has a high main left. Let's not forget this.
Now you start caring.
No, he has 2 high mains left.
No, he has...
No.
He has 1.
Right.
He played 1.
2 have died.
He already played 2 high mains.
Yeah.
Or are you counting the second web spinner?
Yes, that's right.
Well, with Feign Death, I mean, he could have like 4 high mains left.
Yeah.
We're not exactly sure.
Yeah, that's good. You hero power phase, you don't play the... You just maximize the hero power. And next turn, you just steal whatever he plays.
Not exactly.
Except it's Dr. GG, because that card is very good.
What now?
No, he's gonna Harrison.
Yeah, definitely. And Shredder.
Yeah.
Like, how does he still have so much life? That's insane. But the Hunter played...
Well...
It was that brawl turn.
Yeah.
That's the fact that his Shredder lived through that is actually so silly.
It's like having the game of his life with Wario.
Okay. I don't think you want to freeze trap Harrison.
No.
I think you'll probably steal it.
Yeah, but this...
No, I think you just play the no. Actually, maybe you do freeze trap it.
Or you steal it. Like, it's insane
yeah,
amount
just
of tempo.
Steal it.
It's 10
steal
damage
it.
On the board. You can also...
And he can use hero power.
Yeah, and you can play the freezing trap. No, you can't. You can just hero power. It's better. No. What are you doing, sir? I don't think it... Might
you know,
be
the thing is, he's looking at Feign Death, and he's like, I need more! So he's refusing to use it till he has 2 death rattles.
Maybe he plays only 1 bow. It can be, right?
Yeah, it could be.
Because he plays a lot of, like...
Like, he probably has 2 quick shots in here. Yeah, he could be playing 1, though. It's possible.
Then Harrison is a dead card. He will never play 7 on the Harrison.
That's not as good as Dr. Boom, is it?
No, it's close, but...
I think if you're the warrior here, you play as safe as possible, which means you'll never really play Alistraza. So the Sylvanas combo is never really going to be good.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's so good.
Not really.
Yeah, stealing a minion for 2 mana, that is pretty bad.
You attack
right.
Face, proc the freezing, you kill the Shredder, you don't care about your life because you play double Sludge Belcher, and you win.
Mm.
You have the Dr. Boom for next turn.
You also have the Dr. Boom for this turn.
You said you want to play as safe as possible, that's like as safe as possible.
Yeah,
you save the Alexstrasza for some random quick shots phase, heal yourself up, you have the 8-8. Hunter doesn't play BGH. Maybe 1 Hunter's Mark. He needs the Hunter's Mark for the Sludge Belchers. Then he loses. to the 8-8. I can't believe that the Boris is winning this game.
Well, you think he's winning it right now, but when he plays double Sludge Belcher and we see another Feign Death off the top, ain't no thing.
That Sylvanas will be interesting. What will happen?
Oh my God! Look at all those Feign Death targets.
What?
I didn't
expect that. I've seen a lot of decks, but
all right, it's Feign Death time.
You steal the Sludge Belcher, right? With the Feign Death Sylvanas.
Yeah. And then Harrison goes down.
Oh yeah, that's
and good. And then the Shredder gets owned by Freeze Trap.
That's the right play.
That's really good.
I would do that.
But you get a Doomsayer. Sorry.
Whoa! The game suddenly. Oh my God! This game is awesome.
So unfortunately, there's no spells in our warrior's hand right now.
So you don't quick shot this turn, I guess. Right?
No, you leave the quick shot for now.
Oh my God, how did that happen again?
I like right now that Lothar has to read this card. This makes me very happy. This drops out of your shredders all the time. What are you doing? Anyone that plays Hearthstone, this is falling out of shredders left and right, man, every day.
So he has a couple shredders. Suddenly, it doesn't look so bad for the hunter.
Yeah, it does. It's just Dr. Boom. Who cares?
One card.
Dr. Boom.
Dr. Boom clears the board, basically.
The thing is, it might clear the board too effectively.
I want to see.
It might boom down Sylvanas, and Sylvanas might take Dr. Boom.
If that happens as well this game, I don't even know.
You know what I want to see is that he has to use a Feign Death while Lorewalker Cho is out, and then a Feign Death goes to the warrior who has all these Death Rattle minions also, and then he wins through Feign Death Boom Bots. Hmm. Think about that.
Hmm. That's
Rip
the wrong
Belcher.
Minion.
Yeah, that's
oh, no,
the wrong
you
minion.
Just killed the Sylvanas, I guess.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh man, you kill one of the shredders and get like a Doomsayer. That's like the right play, right?
It's a good one.
Let's see. Oh yeah, finally he found the right card. Oh, there you go.
Oh, that was played too quick.
Okay, guys, this is the second one of these we've seen come out of a shredder in this game.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it's true.
How many minions cost 2 mana? Really?
67 or 68.
67 or 68? Two of these in one game? Seems likely.
Wait, you can... No, you can't get the new cards, right? Mm-hmm. It's still like a new minion that was released from the second wing that you can get now from Shredders or something.
That's I don't think the there was a 2 minion.
No, I mean from minion. The from like the original cards.
No. There are 0/2 drop minions in Blackrock Mountain.
They probably did that on purpose.
There's a few 4 drop minions, but they're not ones you want either.
Would be cool to see, like, a random...
I think it's the Axe Flinger dude. And in a few weeks, we'd get the Dragonkin, which is actually good.
Yeah, really good. Yeah. Too good.
Not for all classes.
Spiders.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, it's sad that you can't do, like... You know, choice always very interesting. So you attack with the boom and with one bot and kill the Cho first. And then you kill. There you go.
Oh
misplay.
What?
Misplay. That was an obvious misplay. Next try. Come on, really? But now you just attack it and it clears it.
Yeah.
It was like a little bit tryhard, but...
That poor Cho. It was a little bit tryhard.
The thing is, that's bad for the warrior.
Yeah, it actually
of course,
is.
Yeah.
He doesn't know the hand. Use the weapon first. Whoa.
What if you use a weapon, you don't get the boombots?
Why would you do that? I didn't quite see that.
Because now you can big game your Dr. Boom. That's why it's highlighting over it.
Whoa.
What? What is going on right now?
Illuminati.
He was highlighting the...
You take extra. He forgot he has the weapon. Like, he just took extra damage, right? But why would you do that? He was saving damage in the Dr. Boom. But why would you do that?
DM.
Like, the only way you lose is to some random kill command shenanigans, right?
Yeah.
I'm not so sure about that play. Here's the Alexstrasza, I guess. Maybe it's like a super greedy play. You save life on Dr. Boom. You Alexstrasza next turn because he saw one kill command. Skill command.
Oh no, this is the kill command, quick shot, hero power turn.
Yeah.
No beast required. Or you actually suicide the Shredder and get double kill
command.
Oh my
god, you get the beast.
Off of beast.
Obviously.
Yeah.
This may be like two or three. How many?
Yeah. Well, how many are there? There's a hyena that I remember.
The best.
There's the croc.
Yeah.
There's the parrot. That's
yeah, that would be the best one. To get the worst drop, and that actually wins you the game.
Yeah.
That would be awesome. Oh, that's not what you want to freeze trap, man. That's like another 8 damage to the face. But he had the heal bot to counterplay the Dr. Boom. That's actually very smart.
Mm.
That's why it's in there for sure.
Back to 30 life, easy. How is this game lasting so long?
It's Feigned Death deck.
It's gonna go to fatigue.
Actually, the warrior only has 10
death
cards
fatigue
left.
Hunter, man.
I've never seen that before.
The warrior has gone through 20 cards and has not yet put a scratch in the hunter.
But the amount of threats he killed two Savannas, two Hymens, Dr. Boom, like 6 hyenas.
A like bunch of shredders.
Couple, like a bunch of shredders and sludge belches.
This is so awesome. This is the greatest game.
And he's still trading greedy.
This is
going to
be an Alexstrasza turn.
He says Alexstrasza off his life.
Oh no, actually, with the Dr. Boom down, he can finally play his big game.
I wanted to see a Doomsday, and then he has like 3 seconds to think about his turn.
Yeah.
All right.
Quick shot time.
Yeah.
Easy. Oh my god, he has Lutoras as well. So he has definitely one bow. You can't fit on all cards. Mind if I roll knee? To the face, man.
No.
No, god, no.
Not this time.
Because wow. He missed it. Wow.
That deck is tech to beat everything.
Or nothing.
Or nothing. Nothing seems closer at this moment.
It's going to beat everything, man. I hope he plays 2 Feigned Deaths. I mean, he has a full board-ish. Does this count as board control?
It's not bad, actually. Like, if you do the Belcher, which is really defensive, it's going to take you a while to, like, begin to do stuff still.
What now?
And you get the extra draw off the Loot Hoarder. 2 damage is relevant.
Toyota can still take this.
Yeah, absolutely. You know what the really amazing part is? If he actually donated a freeze trap to the warrior, he could have Kazan'd it back.
Oh my god. I mean, he knew he
and
runs
that
Kazan.
The chance of that being like expected was straight up 0.
What do you mean donated?
Like with the
lore walker.
With the Cho.
Oh god. That's crazy.
Oh my god. But he knows
I was
he
like,
plays Kazan.
Donate is a magic card. I don't know.
That would be like the sickest play.
Donate
ever.
Is a terrible magic card.
Not with illusions, man.
Yeah.
I tell you, I've seen some cards recently I'd like to donate.
Okay.
Donate your Doomsayer?
Yeah.
So sick.
Oh my god. So he will leave 6 damage on the board. That's like a lot of damage to give to the hunter. Another Shredder. That's sad.
Look, that's only 18 incoming.
Yeah, yeah. He used Alexstrasza. You might.
Yeah.
I think you just go face.
Yeah,
right?
You go face here.
Easy, like a good hunter player. Should
yeah,
do.
He might have to clear with these minions. 18 is not enough, and he's got 4 in hand. That's only 22 damage. You'll die the next turn.
Yeah. That's a, so funny. The guy with the 8-7 and 10-7 has to he has to clear the.
He's
loot
clearing
loot
orders. He has to clear
the
loot order.
The heal bot,
ooh,
man.
Ooh, no,
heal bot.
Sludge Belcher armor up shield slam is super nice.
Oh, man. Freezing Trap should make it plus three.
To kill the biggest threat here.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah, the potential in card drive might be.
Oh my god, he has like a 50 card Hunter deck. Another one?
That's not it,
that's
man.
That's game.
No, he can get
18.
Oh yeah, he needs something off his own shredder.
Well, I don't think there is anything that works though.
Yeah, there is.
What?
Taunt, I guess. Or
no, a taunt gets killed by the.
Oh.
Because he's got the weapon, so that's it.
Oh man, that's just a little late.
Yeah, that would have been awesome.
Wow, this was a sick game, guys.
Yeah.
I'll never forget this game.
Yeah, this was like, how did the Warrior win this game? Like, that is, when you think about it, that is absolutely crazy.
Well, the last few cards played, I see smiles from both players. That's always nice.
Toyne right now is like, oh, wow.
They both can't believe it, what just happened.
People saw that. That was a crazy game.
Well, the best part is we actually have to see the Hunter played again.
Oh my god, you're right.
Conquest.
He has to win a game with that deck.
Oh, sweet.
That's crazy.
Sweet.
Among the lineup, there's no Kazans in Johnny's lineup there. No Kazan targets.
Yeah, that's true. That Kazan is
not unless
worthless.
The Lore Walker play happens again.
Yeah, yeah.
Small window.
It's possible.
Well, we're jumping into the game here.
1-1 right now.
It is Hunter again against the Warlock.
Oh, this is going.
I think
to be a
Feign
fun
Death
game.
Hunter is definitely favored against Demon Lock, so guys. I've tested this matchup thoroughly, and Feign Death Hunter is definitely. It's got the edge.
So, do you keep the Healbot? Is the question.
No, that's not the question.
That's not the question at all. No, is that?
So,
that's a Split the Shredder mulligan.
Imagine that with Feign Death, man. You get two Lorewalker Chos. You can actually just fill up each other's hands with... Like, you just fill
actually,
up each other's hands with the coin.
Lorewalker Cho is pretty devastating against Demon Lock. Because Demon Lock just does nothing, and then suddenly they do a lot of stuff. And a lot of stuff that they do involves a lot of spells.
Yeah. Like Bane of Doom.
Yeah. Bane of Jiraxxus.
Use Bane of Doom to kill a Lorewalker Cho. The value.
Bane of Doom has been such a cool card.
Yeah. That's a fun card right now.
It's actually a very strong card now.
Yeah. He's got Leprechaun in this deck?
Yeah. It has a Death Rattle.
Duh. Of course. But where's his Harvest Golem? Where was his Harvest Golem last game?
Yeah.
He's playing so many different cards in this deck. Maybe one Webspin or one Leprechaun.
Honestly, the only card there's two of is Shredder. We didn't even see a second High Mage.
Yeah. It's like so many one-offs.
You might be right. Well, why does he need two high mains when he can just keep on getting hyenas?
Yeah.
Maybe even one kill command.
That's a factory high
That's
main.
That's true.
He's having that
like
thing.
He's playing so many different minions.
Yeah.
Two Luthors even. Like, how do you fit all that in with the Feign Death and the Sylvanas and the Dr. Boom and the Ragnaros?
And he's got at least three traps.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Traps.
This is so weird. You know, that's like kind of cool. Like just a one of deck.
Yeah.
With two shredders. It's a good idea. You watch. He probably has one Feign Death too. It's
oh,
like, oh
man. Now this turn was definitely an Argus, but now that you drew the other egg, it's so painful.
It's still an Argus turn.
It's still Argus turn.
Yeah.
Yeah, because there's like by now you probably realize the chance of having an owl is in the negatives.
Like, if he had now Luthor...
Because you've already counted 46 different cards.
He has to bear on everything.
Yeah.
Oh, man. What? He wouldn't give for Gang Up to be a Hunter card, I swear.
Time to flip the coins.
Does he have a faceless for that Baron Rivendare?
Oh.
How sick would that be? Think about
not
that.
Not sick at all, actually, because it doesn't work.
No, it doesn't.
Of course it works. Death Rattle is triggered twice.
No.
Yeah.
The part that works is you are able to faceless that card. That part works.
1/7s are good.
The part that doesn't work is the synergy you're imagining.
No, I'm gonna ignore you. I think it works.
Okay.
Yes, it does work.
Yeah.
No.
You sure?
I think it
How
works.
How sure are you?
Because I played bullcrap like that all the time.
You've tried that specifically.
Yeah. just rewind stream like 3 weeks. I've had that exact scenario like at least 5 times. Cause I play the shaman deck where you pump a minion a bunch of times,
yeah,
and then
yeah.
you play Baron, and then you have like the whole board of that minion. That minion ends up being killed to Zad.
Happens every time.
Yeah.
I don't understand what's going on anymore.
So you got a knife checker. That's good. From the shredder.
Who cares?
Bane of Doom.
It's Bane of Doom time.
For sure. It's
actually,
Bane
no.
Of Doom.
I actually think I actually think Sludge Bushel is a lot better.
They play so many different RNG cards. It's
no, Sludge Bushel is so good right now.
No, Bane of Doom. You get like Marganis like 90% of the time. I think that was a misplay.
Yeah.
I would have played the Malganis during it.
I like five mana Malganis, to be honest, Crip, but I mean...
Yeah, like, how does he kill it?
Okay.
Can Bane of Doom right now give you Gang Boss?
Oh, that would be awesome. Yeah, I think so. Yeah,
you should
course,
be able
of
to.
Of course.
Yeah.
Patch came out today.
But we aren't supposed to use that set of cards until...
Tomorrow.
Mm.
So
or maybe even the day after.
Remake the game then? Sunday even.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we're trying our best here. If that happens, then just whatever. I mean, if you get Imp Gang Boss, are you really going to complain? There's
well, no, but if my opponent cut, I'm like, oh, I don't even... that. My deck isn't prepared for that card.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you'd be prepared for the Malganis.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can get the Malganis, but not the Imp Boss. I
won. Yeah. I like Bane of Doom.
Emperor, man. Then Bane of Doom costs 4.
No, because next turn you're playing Dr. Boom no matter what. So playing this playing Emperor this turn just sets it up for
okay.
quick death.
All right. You're right.
I would have played Bane of Doom last turn. So I would play this again this turn because you get the Marganis. Huh. He gets like Lord
I would have
Lord
prepped
Lord
it out on turn 2, man.
I don't like this.
No, you're right. It looks so tempting, but I have to agree with you.
I mean, the reason you do this is you'd have 2 cards you'd want to play next turn. And let's figure out what he wants to play. Does he want to do Bane of Doom and then Shadowflame as Malganis?
No.
No.
He plays Egg and Dr. GG. Mm-hmm. You play Dr. GG anyways on turn 7. I mean, come on.
Yeah, but if you do Dr. Boom and Egg, you're going to get Unleashed because that's also in the deck.
If he sees that as well, after like seeing Loatep and Heal
Bot. That's going to be really bad because Juggler's going to come out here. Oh, no, it didn't. Wow.
That is the funniest thing ever.
Wait, he has a mech. He has a mech in his hand.
Oh, my God.
He's going to get...
That is so funny.
Oh, nice to buy you. Easy.
Oh, I think the mech in Hero Power was better there. Just to really utilize that mana.
All right, well, I mean, you set up for this Dr. Boom play. Might as well do it.
Yeah.
The Unleash.
Yeah. You don't
get Unleash in there. Just lose it.
It's going to be off the top.
Yeah, if he gets that as well, he must be like so confused. Like, how can he play every single guy?
Leroy in there. It's like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
It's like he's playing the Summoning Portal deck from the single player.
So, obviously, you play Dr. Boom because it's like the only answer for Dr. Boom.
And you also start the chain reaction of bombs, which ends up in one Dr. Boom taking a fatal wound.
You just have to dodge one mine, which is like the egg.
Yeah.
Kind of have to dodge it a little bit.
You don't have to dodge it. You can just hit it twice.
Oh, yeah.
You can pop the egg right now so that one of them kills it.
Yeah.
Happens every time. Mm. I mean, like, you just do it, right? Just slam it.
It is really powerful to do Dr. Boom Feign Death, though.
Yeah, but he's probably thinking about trading those 2 minions into the guy. Does he play around Moltens? Like you?
No. There's just no deck out there that plays Moltens and Egg.
There are, I think.
Yeah?
There might be.
There's so many different super techy demon locks.
Oh, wow. Your second Malganis.
Oh, yeah. Well, why didn't he play the first one? I still don't understand.
It's because if you play it on a bomb, he'll end up dying by the end of the turn.
You're so ridiculous.
Like, he will like bring a minion to 2 HP now. Like, he will bring the Dr. Boom to 2 HP and then he will summon his Morganis. So
he needs the boom bots to really cooperate for that.
Yeah, you have to like hit it with the first boom so you can protect. Then the second, then the opponent's boom bots will hit face and you take no damage because you got the Morganis.
I think we're going to see a Shadow Flame play.
Yeah.
All face, Shadow Flame, heal bot.
So many possibilities.
Okay.
Just to make sure you guys know what
the boom bot
does
there. I wasn't
sure
if the people know.
Yeah.
It is actually 1-4 damage and not 4 damage all the time.
Okay.
Just to make sure.
Yeah. Sometimes, yeah.
I like Shadow Flame. I think Shadow Flame's great. Okay.
What? Whoa, what? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That's a good play. That's a pretty, really good outcome for the bombs. Just poke the egg.
Yeah, but now you just push for face.
Yeah.
Oh, explosive freezing. Thank
you. Yeah. But that's a really good hand for being low.
Yeah. Yeah.
Double healbot Morganis. 2 Morganis, 2 healbots. Mm-hmm. He can even, like, Bane of Doom his own Boomba to get the first Morganis out.
Yeah, I think the Hunter's lost this.
Yeah, if he plays
too much healing.
If he plays Explosive Trap, he kills himself.
Not exactly, but it's close.
19, yeah, it's
well, no,
just
if he plays
damage.
Explosive, then freezing, then 19. Hit the bow into the 4-4.
Oh, that is freezing. Lethal, because Bane of Doom can target the hero.
Oh, yeah, that is true.
Yeah.
But does it? I never saw it. Does it actually
it
spawn
gives
a minion
you,
because
course,
you kill?
Of course.
You know, the demon it gives you is a special demon that doesn't exist, though. It's like
really, if you kill the player, you get
yes,
a demon.
Yes.
Yeah, but it's a different demon. It's like
I'm surprised that you're surprised because I've done this like
I've never seen it
at least 20 times really? Because Bane of Doom is actually a pretty decent card in Arena.
Oh.
And every time you have an opportunity to do that, you do that.
Of course you do.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
And actually, every single time I've done it since the patch, I've actually got a Mal'Ganis.
Yeah.
I'm 2-for-2 with the BM.
All the time.
Bane of Doom.
All the time. He's going to do it.
That just prevented lethal.
That was a good play. I mean, that hand. You just played double. Is he actually
wait a second.
Did he over with the Bane of Doom? You just played 2 healbots. How can you possibly lose?
That's pretty good.
I should have manned up. Played the first Morganis. We will never know if he has the first Morganis.
Hmm.
I think he'll actually Bane of Doom on his turn if it gets passed back.
Oh, please.
I mean, now you...
Let's see it.
Now you play your healbot because that's why it's in the deck, right? So...
Yeah, healbot doesn't seem so good this turn.
You know, the more this deck loses, the happier I get because we get to just see it again, right? Toyota has to win with this deck to actually win.
Yeah.
I bet you in the next round no one will ban this Hunter. In his next match. Yeah.
Hmm.
But.
What is left? Druid.
Druid for Johnny. Hey.
I actually think Druid's great against this Hunter deck.
Is there something that you think this Hunter deck beats?
Yeah, something with like a slow deck would... Yeah, Freeze Mage, actually.
Yeah.
You have the Kazan and the heals, and you can't clear your board because everything is Death Rattle.
Yeah.
It is the ultimate Freeze Mage counter.
Yes.
Well, I mean, I think that like
Kazan
an aggro
hunter
with 2 flares is probably even better.
So no, if someone asks what's the counter to Freeze Mage... Kazan, Feign Death,
Healbot
Hunter.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Of course.
Oh, man.
I was just worried.
Oh, no. Priest. We got to restart your thing again. Can you?
No.
Yeah.
Man, that thing's really screwing up. Whose account is that? Damn.
I don't know.
But like, do I have to quit?
Yeah, you have to quit and re-going.
Okay. Well, at least we see the druid's hand. And from what I can see, it kind of sucks. I actually think you get rid of everything.
Are you doing the mulligan? It looked like you're doing the mulligan here.
Click it. Click it.
Does everything away.
I can't even click. I can't click on anything. It sucks.
They need to make Archon mode for real.
Okay, well, time's ticking.
It's roping.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, baby.
Oh, yeah.
It's getting better. He has the dream already. That's like
this is actually a really good hand.
That's like an auto win.
Yeah.
I actually play Resurrect Priest.
Yeah, I did as well.
And it's...
Obviously.
Resurrect with Injured Blade is better than Injured Blade Circle Heal.
Yeah.
Injured Blade Circle Heal already craps on Druid.
Yeah.
And you still have the circle left, right? In your deck.
I actually dropped circles and North Shards in my deck.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah.
But that's like that's really the dream. That's like the best.
Yeah.
Except the death. Such a good hand.
Yeah, I think... North Shard is not really worth it. Because North Shard is mostly good if you play like combos or buffs. And most of the combo pieces are really bad with Resurrect. And buffs are also really bad with Resurrect.
You can't play also Zombie Chaos or Pyromancer.
You can. Pyromancer is my only 2-drop in that deck. Because if you can just YOLO it on 2. And you know when you need to clear the board, you start with Res on the Pyro, which then triggers the 1 damage.
Oh, it does? Okay. Yeah. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, the thing is, if you play Resurrect Priest, you can't play Cleric. It's like a really big hindrance.
You probably can, but it's weird.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's weird, that's it.
Oh man, that's such a dream. And you buff it afterwards, and Druid can do nothing about it. Like, now Druid needs like Sylvanas, that's like most of the time. That's really most of the time how it goes.
Yeah.
Because you can't like silence it or anything. Oh my god.
Look
if
at
he
that.
Draws a circle.
That's for real. Like,
that's sick.
The druid wasted a turn killing it.
And then it comes back.
Yeah.
For 2 mana.
Yeah.
Stronger.
Yeah, 3 times the health. It's slightly better.
It's pretty sick. I'm very impressed.
And he has the fourth steal and everything.
Yep. It's 2 mana. Play what you played last turn and triple its health. Wait a second. That sounds pretty good.
Yeah, it does. It's all right. So what you're saying is against this, you shouldn't ever kill a minion, basically.
Yeah.
But he can't know.
Yeah, he can't know.
How can he possibly know?
No, he couldn't.
There's no way.
You must consider.
But
it's pretty sick. I like it.
You can't really play around it because he needs to have it, right? He needs to have it in his hand. How can you let an Angel Blade Master live against a priest? You can't do that.
Actually, I don't know if I like Sludge Belcher. The Shade kills it quite well. I guess the good thing is if he does kill it, Holy Nova is extremely good next turn.
Yeah. No, you play the Sludge Belcher.
Yeah.
Because of the Holy Nova. And you don't trade. I don't know. Maybe because... Oh, but
okay.
But I'm not sure because now it would die to Swipe Breath. Like a 4/9 Angel Blade Master is unkillable.
Well, you already used
Wrath. That is actually very risky though. Like to Savage Roar is also useful here. Mm-hmm. Like a 4/9.
Yeah, he can clear it. It's gross, but he can do it.
Yeah. No. He's Innervate Savage Roar, but no, that doesn't get it. How sick would have that been?
That would have been a good
Innervate
job.
Lore into Innervate Savage Roar, clear the board.
Happens every
above
time.
Average. Above average.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He killed one. Oh.
I'm kind of wondering, did he actually kill the correct one? Yes, he did.
Yes.
Maybe
I was
that
actually
was part of the plan.
I was very
camouflage.
He has like such a
strength in numbers.
Sick turn here.
This is what's going to happen. Toyota is going to 2-0 this druid with realer decks.
Yeah.
And then go back to that go back to that hunter deck.
And he's like, oh, damn it, I have to play the game.
He's like, I thought for sure everyone would ban my hunter.
Yeah, like, in no other format, you get punished so hard by bringing one bad deck, like in Conquest. Yeah. If you have one bad deck, you will just drop out. It gets so punished.
Yeah, I was talking about that, I think, yesterday, that it doesn't really encourage players to try new cards. And right now, we are in the try new cards season.
Yeah.
Which kind of blows.
Yeah, a little bit. Where shall I strike? I like this format, though.
Step Blade Master. Reaping more value.
Yeah, that's...
I think I'd Shrink Meister.
No. You heal him back up. Super value.
I wonder.
Attack, heal, and like Belcher?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's forcing, like, I don't see the priest losing. It's like impossible. The, like, yeah. Druid has no bot clears. Once you're this behind the bot, you just lose. I mean, he can Shadow Mantis anything from the.
Oh? Like Tarzan is pretty good here, though.
I think it actually needs to be better than that.
We can talk about fancy plays, because the priest is going to win. Spoiler alert.
Okay.
Because, like, if you Shrinkmeister, Shadow Madness, the Emperor, you get the effect, right?
At the end.
But the priest will get the effect.
Yeah.
Even though the card goes back. I've not seen it, so...
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, it's because... the end of turn effect of the Tharson will happen first because he was played before the Shadow Madness. So the Shadow Madness returns it at the end of the turn after the Tharson triggers. Yeah, the end of turn effects are just like play effects for Death Rattle.
So if I triple Shrinkmeistered a Ragnaros and stole it,
yeah,
then
you'd
that
get,
would work
you'd
like
get
that.
The
yeah, the effect and you get
it. Sick.
But if somehow he played Ragnaros
so I need like
after you Shadow Madness it, it wouldn't work.
It should be like, while the shot is flying, Ragnaros goes back to the other side.
It's him!
It should be like that.
That would be awesome.
No, it
oh
should
my
not.
God. Yes, it should. It should be exactly like that.
It goes back and hits himself.
Wow. Well, that Blade Master is just going to bite the dust, I guess. Yeah. So much for that.
Look, they did a good job.
Yeah. I must safeguard the land. Just the free drops.
Alright, let's see.
Oh, Priest Tharson. Now, what can you do here? There's so many options.
So many possibilities.
Really, though?
Yeah. Whenever I see Emperor and I have more than two cards, it's usually the correct play.
I think I like Shadow Madness Keeper. Just clear the board, leave full health Sludge Belcher.
It's good, but Tarzan, man. Look at this.
No.
Look how many cards he has.
I think it's just the best. Who cares about... You don't have any powerful combos.
I know,
if
but...
If you don't do that, you just lose your Belcher for nothing. And you're getting such a good value doing that play, too.
He might have to spend really heavily, though, to try to kill Tarzan next turn. And then things are even cheaper, Crit.
Yeah, if it survives more than one turn, it's like a win condition. It's like Dr. GG.
No.
You know,
Tarzan hand, you already play everything you want.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, it's good. You know what Tarzan has done to me as a Hearthstone player? It like makes me feel like I'm like my mother or something, where I see something on sale and I think it's a good bargain to buy it. You know what I mean?
Mm.
I'm like, well, I don't need this toaster, but it's 50% off, so I'm basically making money, right? That's what this card is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Yeah, totally.
Oh, man, Vol'jin. Oh.
It gets better and better.
Vol'jin Shadow Man is actually a ridiculous combo, but... it's still unlikely that it'll go off on a druid. Huh.
can just paint it.
Yeah.
But you steal the hell first. Maximum value. I mean,
that
six
is so
toughness
funny.
Is pretty good, right?
Yeah.
So you have a freaking six
you
six on
board. Steal the hell.
Yeah, you steal the hell.
So funny. You guys are so funny.
Mm. I guess he's saving it for the Ancient of War. That will not come out. Yep.
What can Johnny actually draw out here? It has to be like a really crazy Shredder outcome. I don't even know what that is like.
It doesn't exist.
Yeah. Well, I guess he can clear a bunch of stuff.
You don't even clear that much.
Yeah.
Yes, you kind of do. But it's like your win condition is gone, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah. But Priest is getting a little bit lower on cards. You don't know what's in there. That could be like Circle of Healing.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
You know.
True.
I wouldn't feel 100% hopeless right now, but pretty close.
If he top deck second lore, he's like praying to top deck the second lore.
Hmm.
And that the priest is holding circles, two circles or something like that.
Kill Tarzan here. Yeah. You gotta kill the 2/4.
Yeah.
Oh.
What?
That was like 100% misplay.
Yeah.
I mean, the 2/4 kills the 3/2
Yeah.
Not unless Vol'jin decides to steal the health from the 2/4.
Yeah.
Wait. Hold on a second.
Yeah, that works that way.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It is not the worst play I've seen.
It's a play you sometimes do if you shadow mana something with a lot of health.
Yeah.
But why did he do that? That was...
I don't know.
No, it was just... Keep back the keyboard.
Oops.
It's still a pretty irrelevant misplay, though.
Yeah.
Doesn't really change anything.
Oh, man. If he loses the game because of that misplay, that would be sad.
Oh, come on. There's no way.
Sylvanas is not bad. It's like a start. It's a start. And then you draw the second lore. Maybe he did it intentionally because he knew he would draw the Sylvanas. He gives him more minions to steal.
Mm. I must consider.
No?
Grip is not amused by that idea.
Not convinced.
The damned stand ready.
Save the Vol'jin.
Let me change your mind.
It's an important card.
Actually, by itself, it's generally pretty bad.
Usually it forces you to play one smite, because you need kind of... It's very awkward.
I think it's good at double Shadow Madness.
I think it's good, actually, with...
If they have just garbage, it's kill whatever you want and spawn with a lot of health.
I like how it like makes your Holy Nova good against control decks. You just
That's the other thing. Yeah. The single one-card combo that tends to kill Dr. Boom is Vol'jin Holy Nova. Because you only invest the Holy Nova, and the Vol'jin... usually survives.
Good one. We've just 7 health.
If only the heal would happen after the first bot hits it.
Yeah.
Or you just play a light bomb, you mean? Because that's actually the only card that plays one.
Yeah. But.
And 8 damage.
It needs a special circumstance, though. The Vol'jin Holy Nova usually doesn't. So
just that you can't play the. Vol'jin Holy Nova when he plays Dr. Boom because it's 3 turns later.
Oh yeah, of course. But
because you usually play Dr. Boom on turn 7 and win. That's like how it goes.
Alright, so
this is
Toit
go
is still in this. What's that?
Game 5. We had so much fun with the Hunter, you might forget that the Mage deck won the first game.
Oh yeah!
So we're back to Hunter.
Hunter versus
Druid.
That's the final game. Final boss.
And while normally I would lean towards the Hunter beating the Druid, I don't know this time.
I still think it's not too far off.
I mean, if he's dropping too low, he has the heel butt to play around combo.
Even though the Hunter deck is so random and stuff, I feel like it curves out pretty well. Yeah. Like he hasn't had a bad opener yet in terms of mana. And that's really all you need against the Druid. You just need to apply the pressure so he starts trading with your garbage. And the Druid's not going to kill like high mains after Feign Death. And
no. No.
Do you think that Toyota with his Feign Death Hunter will draw, though, his Nesbitt, Helmuth, whatever guy that kills a beast? Because I think he's playing one in there, right?
What?
You know the 6-3 that kills a beast when it comes into play?
You mean the 5-3?
I thought it was 6-3.
Is it a 6-3?
It's a 6-3.
Yeah. Okay.
Hammett Nessing Barry. Oh,
I have golden.
Played him so many times.
He's a really great card. It's actually a pretty good card when you play the 30 legendary format because there's quite a few good legendary beasts.
Yeah.
And the tempo swings in that matchup is huge.
Yeah.
Like,
and that's a very popular format. Yeah. 30 legendary deck cards.
But he has Hunter Creeper as well. Like, he didn't play Hunter Creeper the last two games.
No, he didn't.
He has a 50 cards deck.
That's why I think
he has like
a
one of everything. Like, everything.
Okay. Well, what the Druid doesn't have is a good opener.
Well, if he draws perfectly, having 30 different cards is really good.
Yeah.
Actually, this hand sucks. You're all in on the Belcher.
Yeah. But the Belcher will get
nothing
killed so easily.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hmm. Oh.
Oh, I think you. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would cycle the Wrath.
Yeah, innovate.
Yeah, I like the Wrath cycle.
Innovate
Tower.
That 5/5
is
going to
be way
so
better.
Strong.
Yeah.
Actually, no. I would Hero Power, because then Tharsis would make the Wrath cost 1, and you could play the Wrath along with the Belcher on the following turn.
Okay, you could, but I'd rather have another card cost 1 less than Wrath, I think.
Mm.
Not that card that he just got.
I was about to say, I know what he doesn't play. Animal Companion. We haven't seen Animal Companion.
You just missed another one.
Impossible! How can you play it? I was actually saying Animal Companion is not in the deck. Yeah.
And how Master 2?
No way!
How many beasts does he have in this deck?
No way! One.
He has a Web Spinner, an Animal Companion, and a Haunted Creeper, right? And I guess, well, he gets a lot of hyenas.
Yeah.
It makes sense.
Oh man, he got me there.
I hope he draws his Defender of Argus next, though, so that he can trade into Tarzan easily.
And the game also almost meant to fatigue, like in the Warrior game. Yeah. And we still only saw like 30% of the day.
What do you do here, though?
Oh my god. He has 2/1 mana, Wild Growth. This is sick.
I think.
This turn sucks.
I think I like the Houndmaster, the Haunted Creeper, just push for face. Because you have Quickshot, you have the bow, yeah. You have more annoying minions.
Who cares if he has 0 mana Wild Growth?
Nobody cares about that.
It doesn't matter.
You still actually have to draw good cards.
Yeah.
It is still scary, though. Like you, from my experience... Leaving this card alive is usually not a good thing. If he comes out with the 2-mana swipes, it's like... he's gonna do it. He's listening to Crip. He's like, Crip's just said, go for face.
No, he's trading. He's trading.
My play was the hit on the Haunted Creeper.
Yeah.
Fine. You know what we just had to see from Johnny Druid? He had to switch over the piece of paper where he's trying to write down all the cards in the Hunter deck.
Yep.
Because he ran out of room on the first side of the paper. He's like, wait, what?
We still haven't seen everything, by the way.
No, there's still cards missing here.
Yeah. What?
I know that
it just
still
doesn't look
here.
Like a full deck yet.
Yeah. There's
3 or 4 cards missing still.
Yeah, something extra is missing. the special something. That's a good card.
I just can't wait till he draws a Ragnaros. That's like when I can relax.
That's so sick.
Like yeah, that is really sick. Freeze trap and a bow.
Yeah, so good against Shredder. When you have a board already, that's so good. He has 24 life. He's going to win this game.
No, he doesn't have 24 life anymore.
Not anymore.
You know, it. I don't know who won between RDU and Nimsh, but I want to see this deck try to win against one of those players. Nimsh beat RDU? Okay.
Wow.
So Nimsh
did RDU win any games in the tournament?
Did Nimsh 3-0'd? Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
RDU just went home 0-6.
Look at this. Look at this. He stole the secret and it's going to get stolen.
Oh, my God. The dream.
And a Pagel, of course. Of course a Pagel. I'm in shock. And here's what's going to happen. The Kezon Mystic might have to bounce from this so
let's
he can
just,
steal
hold
again.
On. No, let's just take this a step back. How much better is this than seeing Control Warrior versus Control Warrior? So much
better. This is better than anything
but
I've ever seen.
I played Kezon just to steal back my own secrets because everyone played Kezon. It is actually the thing.
It's a good strat, man.
Maybe he's playing it just to protect his own secrets.
But the thing is, it's not going to work because
gonna
Freeze Trap is going to trigger on the Kezon.
No, he's going to quick shot it. He can't let that get stolen.
He's gonna steal the next one.
Kezon should have a death rattle that gives you a secret steal as well, I think.
But you don't care. Like, he will die.
Actually, I think Kezon should have a death rattle that just puts up a worthless secret. When your opponent attacks you, that's it.
It just triggers.
It just triggers.
It just triggers in like fireworks, like animation comes up.
Yeah.
I think that's a great idea, actually. I love it.
Actually, Blizzard forgot to implement random secrets, cards that spawn a random secret.
Oh, that would be awesome. Could you see its mana cost at least? You're like, oh, it's a paladin secret. That's fine. And then it's eye for an eye.
Yeah, some random secret. Death Rattle spawn a random secret. That's nice.
Oh, man.
Why just one? It's usually the secret interaction that really does it. Like, what if you had a legendary? It was like the Dr. Boom of legendaries.
Okay.
Where, you know, it's like a 7 mana, but it's like a 3-3, and spawns 6 random secrets on your character.
It just, you can't even see the portrait unless you know the hero power. You don't know which.
Well, no, that's the RNG effect. 1-6 random secrets.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, my God.
It's always 6 secrets, man.
That is fantastic.
So the Hunter's got to make a play.
He played around the Baron Geddon. The Baron Geddon. Did you draw a card from Pagel? No, right?
No. Oh, he didn't?
No.
Oh, so
that
that's not
unlucky.
A crossover.
I think I like Belcher Ping.
Yeah.
I think pinging is just good from this point.
What? By the way, last turn I wouldn't have killed the quick shot at the Kezon. It doesn't matter. If you get another charge on the bow, you just have enough damage with the quick shot to push over 3 turns. 2 turns. If your Kezon survives 1 turn. Mm.
All I care about right now is seeing that web spinner give him 2 King Crushes off of Baron Rivendare.
Yeah, actually, Belcher web spinner is good because you have the Rivendare in hand.
Yeah.
If he doesn't have a swipe, he will just refresh his hand for a couple of beasts. Fishing all day.
Yeah.
But he got the swipe now because of the fishing.
Also, I'm pretty sure you're close to dead to combo. What to do? One Savage Rose is gone, though, isn't it?
No, he didn't use one.
Okay.
Yeah, but this looks like...
Looks like a Druid's game now.
Hmm. Yeah. It's like a clear with swipe. Swipe your power is clear. With Keeper Trade into Shredder.
Well, he's gonna
can't,
get one
he has
bounced.
The freezing, yeah. So.
Yeah, I think the Keeper goes face, the Belcher goes Shredder. Then you swipe and hope he gets a 1 health minion out
of
the Shredder.
He knows the secret, right? He stole it back. Like he knows. 100% knows it's a
priest. Oh my god, he got a death rattle minion. That's a beast. This was a perfect grab. No, if he yeah. has Baron Rivendare and uses Feign Death with that guy, and then he draws his one mind control tech and steals back the 3/3.
Just right? One?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yes.
You know, whenever you're like in a losing position, this is the card you want to draw. When you're in a winning position, this is the card you want to draw.
The beast, right?
Close, close.
Okay.
25% chance to pick the right card.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Next turn, actually, Baron into Belcher is really strong.
Isn't it amazing? I think, like, the Hunter was behind before he drew this card.
Yeah.
Now he's in a dominating position.
This is fantastic.
Oh, but he's fishing.
Dude, did you see the Warrior game? The Warrior had, like, 6 cards left and 130 life. He's fishing himself to death.
Oh my god.
That's the strategy.
What if he draws a Feign Death here?
That's just a misplay.
That's lethal. Feign Death is lethal. Easiest lethal. And all bombs go to
oh,
the
Oh wow.
Face.
Eh. I was joking about that fatigue thing, but.
Wait! Feign Death, Baron Rivendare, pew pew.
Yeah.
It's like 30 damage. How much did you calculate? 50 damage or something.
That belongs.
Oh man,
that's a sick turn though.
Yeah, it is.
But the cards kind of suck. Like all the minions, except BGH, obviously.
There's just a lot of them. And them being a lot of is quite relevant as a druid.
But then you draw one kill command, and that's usually enough.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man, I hope he draws Feign Death and the bombs a lot. Oh, man. Please dub deck Feign Death with Baron Rivendare. That would be the coolest finish ever. Oh, but that's not too bad.
He doesn't have a beast.
Yes, he
well,
has.
The beast.
Yes, the beast.
The beast himself.
But it actually doesn't improve the
oh, first. It works! Oh, my God, he's going to hit with all bombs face. Oh, my God,
he
it's
could.
Happening. It's happening. He has the kill command hero power. That's lethal. He sees it! He sees it! He saw the lethal!
Oh my god.
That's lethal! Come on.
That was actually terrible.
That was wow. Wow, that was so bad. Come on, another
shot. Aren't you glad Baron was played for that one damage on Pagel?
Come on. Hit it for face. No!
Alright, that's a little bit better. That's a little bit better.
Now we can play Sludge Belcher.
Yeah.
Oh, that's an amazing combo.
Wow.
This is the first time we've... And the last time we've seen it.
No, you know, if Johnny actually pulls this out, we get to see Nimsh not ban this.
Oh, Black Knight.
Are you kidding? He's drawing so many minions.
He's drawing really insane, though. What he's not drawing are combo pieces, though.
Yeah.
He doesn't play the combo, he just plays a Savage Roar.
Okay.
I mean, he's not drawing any spells except this one Savage Roar. Taita must be thinking, oh my god, he's screwed.
I think if you Savage Roar defensively, you shut out the game. If you do Black Knight on the Sludge Belcher and then Savage Roar, you can completely wipe the board using Pagel.
Happens every time.
I wonder.
But then you used your Savage Roar. It gives like the Hunter more turns. Sort of.
You have the Ancient of Lore though.
He doesn't. The best would be if like he has no answer for the beast, which he doesn't. Like he played the BGH and some. He can somehow clear the. I mean, he has the kill command. I want to.
Man, I was gonna say if he played that Drillclaw in charge, he would have died to a faceless top deck kill command.
Faceless top deck kill command?
Yeah, he has faceless in the deck.
Of course, he has a faceless.
The beast is actually the play here. The beast kill command with the Navis, and trade one slime into 5/1. Mm. He has no answer for the beast.
He does, though. Oh, my God.
Mm. Yeah, it's true.
And he has one slime to protect it, sort of.
So you really need to protect that one.
But if you get the 9 damage, then you win.
No, it's not going to be enough. He's going to Savage Roar for that. Savage Roar is just excellent.
It's a good card. Mm.
Yeah.
You can Savage Roar Keeper, if anything.
But then Kill you're beast. Like, the board is kind of weak, right? But he has the quick shot. He will quick shot into the one Unleash the Hounds we haven't seen yet.
Whoa.
Just kill him. It's still a decent turn.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he can leave the slime up. Yeah. Baron Rivendare.
Yeah. That's actually. Wait.
I almost forgot that Baron Rivendare is a minion that can attack.
Yeah. That was swipe, though.
Oh, that's not a bad swipe. Swipe Savage Roar. Savage Roar is 2 mana. You can do everything. He even has Black Knight. For a slime.
I wonder.
No.
Black Knight, Savage Roar. Hero power.
Black Knight for a slime. He's going to be kicking himself when he draws that Fen Creeper.
All right, Artosis.
I mean, this slime is probably like the last minion he can Black Knight, actually.
That we know of.
Could be.
Maybe he pulls Could out be. Tyrion or whatever. I don't know if that is actually...
That's a lot of 3/3s.
Oh yeah, that sucks. Obviously.
That's two golden Finkel Einhorns, man.
That sucks.
Finkel Einhorns.
Oh man, that's like the worst deck.
I don't think I've ever seen a golden one.
No, I haven't seen a golden one of these.
I certainly haven't seen two golden ones at the same time.
No, this is a new day of Hearthstone for us all.
Alongside a Pagel.
Would you have
Seems
ever,
right.
Would you have ever expected to see such a board?
I would have figured this all dropped out of various shredders is the thing.
This is like the winner's bracket, right?
That's a 2 mana card.
Oh, that's actually pretty cool.
Yeah, but you can't get something like that out of a shredder.
No.
No.
Unfortunately.
It's not a card.
Yeah. I think it should just be a card, though.
Yeah, why not? Who cares?
I hope he plays 2 quick shot. Just quick shot phase. I mean, you can't start trading.
Actually, that's a Kill Command top deck lethal.
If he plays 2 Kill Commands, I'm kind of scared. I'm kind of scared.
It could be.
He played 1 Kill Command already.
Or, with both swipes down, what about Haunted Creeper quick shot the Haunted Creeper?
That's the winning play.
Thank you.
All right, let's see it.
Oh, no. What? Whoa.
Not bad.
But he's dead, right?
To what?
Yeah, to what?
3, 7, 8, 9, 10.
10 damage is 23 life.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. That's a nice top deck. But that's not lethal.
No.
But that's like a good card.
Oh, that's close, though. That's 8 from Savage Roar. 8 plus 7's 15, 16 hero power, 17, 18.
So you gotta
keeper. I think he has the defensively Savage Roar again.
Oh my god. And then he draws the second.
And I think he needs to kill off Pagel before he draws more cards.
How many cards are left in this deck? I can't believe that he has 7 cards left in his deck.
Exactly.
Pagel's just going.
Yeah, guys, I just fatigued a combo druid with my Highlander Hunter.
That's a fatigue hunter. Yeah. I cannot see. Now he plays like Deathlord with his next draw.
It's fatigue hunter, man. It's
fatigue hunter.
Oh, things are getting pretty serious here.
All right, he's there for business. That's not like the
Yeah, it's pretty bad. Pretty bad draw from Tweedy.
Tweedy.
Is he dead? 15? No.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
But there's like nothing you can do about it.
11, 12.
Yeah. 12.
I got a face. He still got it.
Yeah, we know there's an explosive trap in here.
No, don't kill
it. No, don't kill the pagel.
What's the point in killing it now?
There's no point in killing it now. Absolutely. You're going to prevent another card? No. Go to face. Come on.
You prevent another card, bro.
This damage is significant, too. Everything is significant.
Yeah, every point of damage matters.
Yeah.
I would have really thought about like the quick shots and the kill commands and everything.
I guess he doesn't want... man, what's his name again?
Merrick?
The other guy.
Yeah, is that...
The druid guy.
Oh, yeah, the druid
Cenarius?
Guy. The druid guy.
No, the guy playing the druid.
Oh, is Johnny?
He's the druid guy.
Oh, okay.
Johnny the druid.
Johnny druid. Johnny the druid.
He doesn't want him to draw like a force of nature, I think.
What to do?
But okay, it doesn't matter. It's irrelevant.
You have 5 cards left in this deck.
Oh, yeah, now is actually the play. Now is the time where you can kill off your Pagel so you don't get fatigued down by forcing an explosive in.
You wait until he goes cold light, cold light.
What's that is explosive? Good. Oh, that's a leper now. Oh, that cannot be good.
That trade of the Mad Scientist was actually not a good play because he could have drawn the secret.
Well, that's it.
Yeah.
There is no more.
But we will see it again, right? Because he's not out of the tournament. He will play the Hunter again 3 times.
Yeah. 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 Like Nimsh. I don't think Nimsh is going to ban that deck, tell you the truth.
I need to sleep today, man.
He didn't draw the Feign Death, unfortunately.
It's
Feign
too
Death
bad.
Lepanon would be the combo to win.
Why was his poor... His poor Unleash at the bottom of his deck the whole time.
Yeah.
Can't believe that the druid almost fatigued.
It's 5 cards left. 5.
Wow. And this means Janie Druid actually got out in first place in this group.
Yeah, pretty good stuff.
The like ultimate underdog of this tournament.
That really could have gone either way.
Yeah, it absolutely could have. Especially if he had banned the Hunter.
Oh, man.
Wow.
You know what's just?
What?
Ignite and
yeah, qualified Johnny guys Druid. Have crushed their group so far.
Yeah, they're both first.
Who's the third person that qualified that's here? Can't remember.
Sixer. You mean the first person overall? Or what?
No, there's 3 people that qualified
are
that are
three?
Playing
oh.
here. Johnny
yeah.
Druid and...
Merrick. Was it Oskaka as well? I don't know if...
Oh, yeah, Oskaka
oh, it was
did.
Oskaka.
Yeah.
Didn't he well,
let's
get
see
first
how he's
place
doing.
In this group?
How's he doing?
He's crushing it as well.
Well, I want to see just how badly.
Yeah, he won his group as well.
Oh, yeah, it's true.
Three,
top.
The 3 people that qualified. Congratulations, Johnny Druid. The 3 people that qualified through the open qualifiers all won their group.
Yep.
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
It's nice.
It's well deserved. It's well deserved. Okay, so here, I have a question for you. What do you think about that Hunter deck that you just played against? Did you try to write down all the cards that were in it, and how many did you get to?
Yes, I tried, but there was like almost every card, just one copy. And I was like, what is this deck?
It was
I
close,
I played
though.
Only once against Deathrattle Hunter, just against Gaara. And
this was not that.
Yeah, no. Yeah, it was way different.
Yeah.
Yes.
Way different.
And we were like about to say he has no Houndmaster, no Animal Companion. And then he drew an Animal Companion.
Yes, when he played Houndmaster, Animal Companion, I was like, did he switch deck? Or what?
We were all wondering as well. That was crazy.
There's more good news. Yeah, you got first out of your bracket, but coming up, we're actually going to see that Hunter deck play some more.
It's going to have a new set of 30 cards against Nimsh. Yeah.
It was really interesting deck.
There's actually an even better part of this. Because Nimsh was actually playing during that match, he will get original reaction to all the different cards coming out.
He will.
In likely all 3 Hunter games.
Yeah.
Yep.
It'll probably catch him off. It'll probably work perfectly this time, and Feign Death just like kills him.
That's so cool. Like every game is a new, fresh experience of the deck.
It plays out a different way every time. I mean, okay, so Janie Druid. I mean, what does this mean to you going into the round of 16? This is your first live event. You qualified through the open qualifier. You won your group, a very hard group.
Yeah. Yes, I didn't expect it. I just came here, just wanted to win at least one match.
Hmm. Must be pretty
awesome. I don't know what to
say. So did RDU.
Well, that didn't work out.
No. Oh, boy.
He got 6-0'd.
No, he got 0-6'd.
That's, yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, you guys have any more questions for Janie Druid?
No, I just... I thought I'd just look over the bracket because the other brackets are set. We've just been moving slow in this group.
Yeah, yeah. It looks like Maverick and Life Coach get out of that last group, which means we have only one more player going to that round of 16.
And it's going to be either Toide or Nimsh.
Yeah. All right, cool.
Well, we'll have that for you guys when we come back in a few minutes.
Yep. Janie Druid, thanks very much. And
congratulations
man. That's like a sick victory there.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So, all right, guys, we're going to be back after a quick little commercial break here. So don't go anywhere. Last match of the day coming.